keeping a large rescue group, it is a daily struggle to keep going. But there are other shelters and rescue groups out there that have it just as difficult. I saw a post on social media about a wolfie type dog that was at a very small rural shelter in South Carolina. The shelter staff was having behavioral problems with him, growling at them through the cage. They couldn't get into the cage with him. They couldn't put a leash on him. To see a dog that is growling and snapping and snarling through a fence in that environment, though intimidating, you have to take into consideration the big picture. And that is a dog that has just been either yanked out of its home or caught on the street and then thrown into dog prison. And he's probably petrified. They were getting desperate. When the shelter announced that they may have to euthanize this dog, that's when I felt really bad. And I said, you know what? We don't have room, but I feel like I have to get involved somehow.
Oh, hey.
How are you?
Are you Carissa?
Oh, you're Carissa.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm Tia.
Yeah.
It's my daughter.
Hi.
On the ride.
Hi.
My name is Carissa. I work for Lancashire County Animal Shelter. We take in stray animals. We try to place them with rescue groups and find them good homes.
Today's the big day.
It is. Finally, Gunner gets to leave.
See, he was a stray?
He was a stray. Animal Control got a call out that there was a dog running loose, but then the lady had posted it on Facebook wanting to see if they could find the owner. Nobody, you know, come for him. So then everybody's like, it's a wolf, it's a husky,
yeah.
You know,
yeah,
all that
yeah.
stuff. This is the first time I've seen a husky-type mixed dog here before, since I've been here in 3 years.
So I was telling my daughter-in-law that the issue with him has been the leash.
Mm-hmm. He just, whatever it is, that tension on his neck. When Gunner first came into the shelter, I tried to get him on a leash and he did not like it at all. He growled when we tried to put the slip lead over him.
You go to put that, like, I don't know if it's the coming at him or what it's like, the person.
Yeah, maybe it's,
he like gets all like weird. Huh. I tried to get him out to walk him, but he didn't want that.
Yeah. So. When you were describing his behavior here, I said, oh, so typical.
Yep.
Yeah.
It's like not even
confined.
And they don't do good in shelter.
Yeah. You know, a shelter environment is equivalent to like being in jail or prison for a human. You know, they have their freedom and now they're confined. They're confused. So what could appear to be aggression is just fear. It's just straight out panic.
All right, well, let's go meet him for a second. I'm not gonna take him out or anything. We're just gonna go meet him, see what we're up against.
Walking into this animal shelter to meet this dog for the first time, I don't know what I'm walking into.
Gunner's over here.
But all I know is that if we were not able to get him, they were gonna have to euthanize him.
Gunner!
Hi, Bubbas.
Hi, oh, you're littler than I thought. Phew, okay.
How about you?
You're teeny tiny.
Hi!
You're teeny tiny.
It's okay, buddy. It's okay.
Come here,
bud. Gunner,
come here.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. When I walked in to see Gunner, you know, he was so afraid and he was growling, but he was afraid and he was slinking around like this and he was so afraid. Look at, see what he's doing? He's trying to get out. He wants to get away. Oh, he peed. We scout you. We scout you.
Hi, it's okay.
I'll tell you what I'm thinking. I want to bring Augie in here. Let him get to low Augie through, you know, and have Augie walk with him out.
Good boy.
I think that would be the way to go.
Good boy.
The type of dog that Gunner is, the Arctic breeds, you know, the huskies, you know, and wolves, they love being around other dogs. They're definitely like pack animals. Stay, stay.
Hi, big guy.
What are you doing?
So I decided to bring out my dog, Augie, who is the sweetest, biggest, dopiest dog ever. I wanted to bring Augie in to make Gunner feel more confident and know that his friend was there to be there with him.
August, this way.
I always like to get a dog with the least amount of stress for the dog.
Aug.
So, come on. You know, I want this to be like his freedom ride. I want him to be happy that he's coming with us.
You try him. Yeah. Make sure I'm not the bad guy here.
He's not
good
at all.
Like, what's he doing? Come here, Lindsay. Look, look. There you go. There you go. Good boy.
I told him, too, you know, get down on the floor, you know, so you're less intimidating, you're not standing over him, and just start to make friends. Feed him treats, and we had some hot dogs, and just, you know, let him know that we come here as friends.
Look, it's Augie. Oh, good boy. Oh, you like doggies.
Gunnar seemed really receptive to him being there.
I'm almost tempted to rodeo it and just open the gate and Luke
let
coming
him
out.
Go.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
Let him come, yeah. Rather than go in to get him.
Yeah, no, I agree.
I had a gut feeling that all Gunnar wanted to do was just get out.
Do you want to double loop him? Or just
no, I think once he gets out, I have faith he's gonna be fine.
Yeah.
So instead of going into the kennel where he felt trapped, we opened the cage door and allowed him to kind of come out.
Come here, let him come to you. Don't trap him in the corner. Here.
Come here. Come here. Come here.
Come here. Come here.
Oh, God. Oh, boy. There you go.
He's like, what just happened?
Mm-hmm.
Hello.
Okay.
It's okay, buddy. Look at that. You got a friend. You got friends.
He's already acting better.
You got friends.
Come on.
You know, I took advantage of the situation. He was more interested in Augie and her and not paying attention and phoop, right over his head.
Oh my God, he wants Augie.
Come on, here you go.
Hey.
Reach
hi.
Come here.
Look at that. Yeah. You got friends. You got friends. You got friends. You got friends.
I know, he's so cute.
You got friends. You got friends.
And watching Gunnar's behavior and body language, I mean, he just wanted to play with Augie. He just wanted to be with his new friend.
You're going this way. You
come on.
You have a job to do, buddy.
Hey. Good boy.
Okay, you go play.
Just follow
him. He's like, wow, friends.
Good boy.
Gunnar, look at you. It's crazy to see him like that. It was actually really mind-blowing seeing Gunnar the way he was with Tia and with the other dog especially. He just kind of opened up from the minute he saw him.
Go say hi to Augie. You got new best friends?
Just days ago, we didn't know how he was gonna act or what we were gonna have to do with him. So it really is mind blowing that he opened up that quick and that fast.
You wanna look at this? What's this? Hey, look,
go get it. Let him go, yeah, let him try.
Good boy.
There you go.
Good boy, good boy, did you get it?
I am very grateful for Tia coming to get Gunnar. If he didn't, you know, have her, it wouldn't have been good for him. He would have had to be put to sleep. So this really was a life or death situation for Gunnar.
Good boy, look, you're giving kisses still.
You can't convince me that any shelter worker wants to kill a dog or a cat. They don't want to euthanize them. It's all about saving lives. So to have a happy ending for Gunnar after going through so much with him, it was a great feeling to see the shelter workers happy as well.
Bye, thank you.
Bye.
We don't know what Gunnar's future will hold as far as getting a home or what, it, you know, I mean, he's safe. He's gonna be with us. He's gonna, you know, run around our big yards and he's gonna be happy.